Why is there 13.8 million Americans collecting unemployment benefits when we have a massive amount of job openings? Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcad channel, original, also known as Dimcad. Alright, first, I'll talk about the Pennsylvania audit. Okay, there's a great deal of resistance for the election audit for 2020 as far as Pennsylvania. There's resistance in Philadelphia. There's resistance as far as Tioga County. That county just refuses, it's supposed to be a GOP county or whatever, but they refuse to really hand over information for that audit. Speaking of which, in Arizona, Maricopa County is refusing to hand over certain information for the canvassing in that situation as well. So there's a great deal of resistance. Of course, that Arizona audit has been going on for at least 2 months. My question is, do you think anything's going to actually come of this? You think this is a complete waste of time? I think it'll be worth it if we at least learn what happened in 2020. We get an accurate account of what happened in 2020, regardless of the results. That's what I'm looking for. And hopefully we can get that. But do you think it's going to actually amount to anything? Okay, 13.8 million Americans are collecting unemployment benefits. 13.8 million Americans collecting unemployment benefits at a time where there's a massive demand. There's massive amounts of job openings right now. Some people criticize the type of jobs that are available. Some people are saying these jobs don't really pay enough. And when you look at the inflation situation, basically the value of the dollar decreasing, I'm not really looking at the nominal numbers. I'm not looking at the nominal situation. I'm looking at as far as how much will this dollar buy. And that's basically what inflation really means. It means you get less for your dollar. That's essentially what it comes down to. A lot of people just don't see the incentive of the work, especially when they get all these benefits. I think now people with kids are now getting additional $250 or $300 a month. So just for having the kids for as part of the whole stimulus package, the latest stimulus package going on right now. So I know a lot of, some people are getting that. So that's going on. There's also talk of even a fourth stimulus package, which, you know, wouldn't surprise me at this point. But what's happening with the workforce? Well, okay, in 2019, I think we had additional 3.2 million people applying for the benefits, for Social Security benefits. I don't know if they actually got it or not, but a lot more, that's how many baby boomers are applying for it. Also, and that's just regular Social Security benefits. You also had additional 2.7 million people applying for the disability as well. I think overall it's 25 million people getting benefits, Social Security benefits, regular ones. Somewhere around 25 million or so around that period of time. Obviously, you got people who are entering the disability system who aren't truly disabled and they can actually work, but they just don't want to work. Of course, people who really are disabled and they cannot work. So I'm not against that, but I am against people who can work and they choose not to work. Whether it be people collecting these unemployment stimulus unemployment checks or whatever, whether it be people collecting disability when they know that they can actually go out there and work. There's a strong incentive for people not to work. Cliff High was talking about this just recently. You know, a lot of people don't want to. It takes more money to get people to go out to work if they're getting free money from the government. And I completely understand that. What's happening with the baby boomers is very complicated, and I'm gonna link you guys up to a really good article. It's not just okay, black people don't want to work. It's just a situation where okay, a lot of the younger generations, they don't have the skills to replace a lot of these plumbers, these electricians, people like that. That's becoming an issue. It's not just regular jobs that we're talking jobs where we need this for the function of our civilization. That's a big part of the issue going on right now. So like I say, I'm seeing this in my own life where people are complaining that a lot of people just don't work. And it's not just low-end type of jobs. I'm telling you, there's decent paying jobs where they're having trouble finding people to come in and work. And whereas a few years ago, the same type of position had like 50, well, maybe 20 interviews lined up for that one position. I've seen it myself. And now it's like, okay, we can't even find anybody. Vaccine issues, they continue to have some issues. They keep saying that these heart issues are really rare. Some story about some 15-year-old boy in the ICU after 6 days after getting the vax. I'm still coming across stories like that. There's some questions about the reporting, the system in which they're reporting injuries and deaths. I mean, can you really trust what's actually being reported? All right, Pfizer applied for a third dose. They want to give people a third dose, and they were rejected by the FDA. Apparently, the FDA didn't see the actual need for this third one. Here's my question. Remember when they were saying, oh, we get the vaccine, we can return to normal life? Why? And now we're talking about, what, a third dose? Question of the day, the strike teams. What are you going to do if these survey teams or whatever, these COVID vaccination teams show up at your door to try to talk you into getting the vaccine if you haven't already had it? Is it a sign of desperation? It's clearly a sign of desperation. It's clearly a sign of desperation. And last time I checked, you know, vaccines are supposed to encourage antibodies in the system in your body to help provide immunity against a disease. But if people are able to get this vaccine, they're still able to get this disease. Is it truly a vaccine? I'm just throwing that out there. I don't know. Just a question. What would you do? What are you going to do if they show up at your house? You're going to try to talk to them and try to actually convert them over to your side, seeing things? If you have some concerns about this vaccine, because again, it usually takes years for a drug to really get through the market, get through all the testing and all the research, but we did this in record time, and we don't know the long-term effects of this. I'm just wishing people the best. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for listening. What do you see happening with our economy as far as the baby boomers leaving the economy and the work shortages? The work shortages is going to contribute to higher prices, because if it's harder for you to get people to come in and do a job, it's at some point you got to pass the cost on to somebody else. It means you got to pay more for somebody who is willing to do the job, which means, okay, you got to compensate for that by increasing the prices. Just a thought. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.